about without having some baptismal water, can we? So I'm going to just bless some water for us right now before we begin the service. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt, into the land of promise. In water, your son, Jesus, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into eternal life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. And through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who are here cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. I invite you into a quiet pause to be mindful of God with us here. And as you stand, I invite you to breathe in the love of God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Alleluia, alleluia. Prepare the way of the Lord with paths made straight, and all living things shall see the salvation of God.
Justice, truth, and love. Lift high your praise resounding and joy abounding. Oh, blessed is Christ that came in God's most holy name. Fling wide your gates, O Zion, your Savior's rule embrace. His tidings of salvation proclaim in every place. All lands will bow before him, their voices will adore him. Oh, blessed is Christ that came in God's most holy name.
Finn and Matilda, I'm going to invite you back up here. Matilda, I'm going to invite you back up here again already. For a special Advent time. As they come, I'll begin. In peaceful expectation of his coming to our aid, we pray to Jesus, come to us all. Help us to live in the light and peace of your coming, and give us a longing for your kingdom. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. Timeless grace, you fill us with joyful expectation.
Make us ready for the message that prepares the way, so that with uprightness of heart and holy joy, we may eagerly await the coming of Christ, who reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Children, you may go with Miss Laura for a story and activity if you'd like. Or there's things at the back table too if you want to be there.
In the fullness of your love.
Please be seated for the readings.
The ground shall be made level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, "Cry out." And I said, "What shall I cry?" All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flowers fade, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. Grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of tidings. Lift it up and do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. Thanks. Thanks be to God.
Hear what the Spirit is saying to us today. Gracious to your land, O Lord.
You have restored the good fortune of Jacob.
You have forgiven all the iniquity of your people.
And blotted out all their sins.
I will listen to what you, Lord, God, are saying.
For you are speaking peace to your faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to you.
Truly, your salvation is very near to those who fear you.
That your glory may dwell in our land.
Mercy and truth have met together.
Righteousness and peace have kissed each other.
Truth shall spring up from the earth.
And righteousness shall look down from heaven.
Lord, you will indeed grant prosperity.
And our land will yield its increase.
Righteousness shall go before you.
And peace shall be a pathway for you.
A reading from the second letter of Peter. But do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but he is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, and the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of people ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening in the coming of the day of the God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire. But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. Hear what the Spirit is saying to us today.
Please stand as you're able while we sing the gradual and hear the gospel reading.
There's a voice in the wilderness crying, a call from the ways untrod. Prepare in the desert a highway for our God. The valley shall be exalted, the lofty hills brought low. Make straight all the crooked places where the Lord God God may go. O Zion, give voice to good tidings, ascend to the heights and sing. Proclaim to a desolate people the coming of their King. The works of pride shall perish, the flowers they shall decay. The power and pomp of nations shall pass like a dream away.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah. See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
But your word, O God, is faithful. Your arm, O Lord, is strong. You stand in the midst of nations, and you will right the wrong. You will feed your flock like a shepherd, and fold the lambs to your breast. In pastures of peace you'll lead them, and give to the weary rest. There's a voice in the wilderness crying, a call from the ways untrod. Prepare in the desert a highway for our God. The valley shall be exalted, the lofty hills brought low. Make straight all the crooked places where the Lord our God may go.
Thank you. Please be seated. Have you ever got yourself into a pickle or a predicament and found yourself somewhere you didn't really want to be? Or perhaps a pickle or predicament happened to you or to someone you love. Maybe this situation happened suddenly or it evolved over time. Whether you choose this path or you didn't choose this one, I wonder if you felt like the people of Israel that Isaiah is talking about. Maybe life took a turn at Wilderness Avenue and you found, or perhaps today find yourself living in a bit of a desert, a barren land. At times we experience being exiled from home, from a place of peace within. In this place, may you know God meets you with deep comfort. May God's tenderness and loving presence be living water to your heart and into any predicaments or wildernesses you may be in at this time of Advent waiting. 2 Corinthians encourages us in that God comforts us in all of our troubles. Then we can comfort those in any trouble with a comfort we ourselves have received from God. I wonder if we can take more time in our lives to be comforted by God. I also wonder if we can receive some self-compassion from ourselves in times of sorrow. And to deeply receive care or compassion from a friend or a family matter, can we let that go in? There are so many, many people this Advent season who need comfort. Many are not in their homes and are living in utter barrenness of even basic necessities. May we remember those. To all dry and weary hearts, to ourselves, those we love, and those in hunger and desolation around the world, may we receive and give comfort. Oh, comfort, my people. I don't know about you, but when someone has compassion for me, they show me some comfort when I've got myself in a pickle or predicament. Like this week, losing my keys again, or something more serious where someone I love and care about has been deeply hurt. Something horrible could happen. But when compassion comes, when someone shows me care and comfort, what a huge difference that makes for me in how I recover or not. God urges us to use tender speech to be encouraging. Last week, one of my grandkids was in a pickle. She was given tender words of care and understanding. We call it synchronizing with where someone is at. Comforting her in this despairing place brought peace to the situation, peace to her heart. She was in a desert. In a sense, her boat was rocking wildly, and rather than jump in and rock it some more, her mom was able to stand on the dock and steady her. Her path was made level. In a short period of time, she could recover. She skipped away, actually. It is quite astonishing. It was over. Peace is restored through that time of being comforted. I wish it were this easy with all despairing places around the globe. But we can bring comfort rather than rock people's boats more. And when we do, each ripple of peace that goes out to our communities and to the world makes a difference. I wonder how else can we make straight the crooked places in our lives and in the world. We are to bring low the high places of misused power, position, prestige, supremacy, and abusive control. These must come down in our little lives and in the big global dilemmas. And we must raise up the low places of the impoverished and those living in places of despair. This leveling way is a massive upheaval and a reversal in the created realm. It is where the glory of God is revealed. I like this. In Acts, the early Christians are called those who belong to the way, those who belong to the way. We belong to this level, fair, peaceful way of God, and that is good news. In this, God gives food to the flocks, where lambs are gathered and carried close in God's bosom, and mother sheep are led. And in God we are at home, at peace. I will say that the wilderness isn't all bad. It does provide a place to prepare. The Jewish people could resonate with wilderness and desert as their ancestors had wandered for 40 years into that place until they entered the new land. The desert is a place of deliverance from exile. And in Jeremiah, we read it is a saving place. And in Hosea, it is a place of betrothal. And for Jesus, it was a place of testing and prayer, and where angels fed him. God is patient. We don't have to rush out of the desert. We use it as a meeting place for God, a place where things are cleared out of the way. It is an Advent place. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. In this Isaiah text, God is clearing that warfare, is declaring that that warfare has ended. And wherever there was iniquity, it has been pardoned. And that from God's own hand, double has been given to bless all that are in need of forgiveness and healing. John the Baptizer calls himself the voice that is preparing this way for Jesus' coming. John was called to this while still in his mother's womb, when pregnant Mary meets pregnant Elizabeth. He knew his role was to prepare the way. You, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, and shall go before the Lord to prepare his way. Without question, John was aware of his personal vocation as he grew up. And from this awareness of having been called, he discovered the symbol of baptizing in the River Jordan. I was reading St. Basil the Great, one of my favorite ancestors of the faith. And he says, the baptism of the Lord surpasses all human powers of comprehension. It contains a glory beyond all that humanity hopes or prays for. It's a preeminence of grace and power, more than the sun outshines the stars. And at St. Thomas, we had two baptisms last month, and I think there's a couple more waiting. But I can attest to this grace, for I witnessed God's glory shining on these faces. When you come for communion, you may want to dip your hand in the blessed water here as a sign of receiving comfort today. Water in a desert, or as a symbol of preparing the way of your own heart and life for Christ's coming, or to claim that you belong to the way, or maybe all three. May this be a place where wilderness is made like Eden. This Advent season and into the coming family and friend gatherings of Christmas time, maybe we can join God and join him in offering pardon and comfort and make straight paths for God to come. Maybe rather than clutter our lives and clutter relationships with stuff, we can be as generous as God is in giving double blessings, even to those, and especially to those who might need pardon and peace. May righteousness and peace kiss, and our homes and our inner dwellings with God be at peace. As we have sung this morning, longing for peace, we turn to you. We also sung Fling Wide. Did you catch those words in that song? And may we fling wide the gates of our hearts, our homes, and our service for Christ who is here and who is ever drawing near. Amen. And as we say together in faith, Holy, 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 holy is the Lord God Almighty,
who was and is and is to come.
We believe in God the Father who created all things.
For by his will they were created and have their being.
We believe in God the Son, who was slain.
For with his blood he gave himself freely for every tribe and language, for every people and nation.
We believe in God, the Holy Spirit.
The Spirit and the bride say, Come. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Please stand, sit, or kneel as is your custom.
God of hope, you raised up John the Baptizer as a herald who calls us to transformation. As we joyfully await the glorious coming of Christ, we pray to you for the needs of the church and the world. God of cleansing and liberating power, give us the courage and perception to see ourselves as we really are and repent of our sin. May the whole church be cleansed and renewed. Come, O come, Emmanuel, come and live in us. God of wisdom and truth, we pray for the world's leaders and all in authority, that they may lead and govern wisely and honestly, without corruption and for the common good. We pray for your blessing and grace upon our Primate Linda, our Bishop John, our priest Lorie, our wardens, and all our lay leaders and volunteers. In our weekly cycle of prayer, we pray for the Urban Aboriginal Ministry, Mr. Stephen Siegerts, and for the Coming Home Society, President Mrs. Linda Adams. We pray for our companion parish in the Episcopal Diocese of Northern Philippines, the Right Reverend Benny Lang Akin, Diocesan Bishop. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and live in us. God of love and faithfulness, may every family be surrounded and upheld by your presence, the conflicts healed and needs provided for, and every act of kindness blessed. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and live in us. God of wholeness, bring your reassurance and healing, your hope and patience to all who are suffering in any way. Today we pray especially for Bev, Norma and Jim, Mary, Roland and David. Bring freedom to all imprisoned by hate or guilt, and a change of heart to all who need to forgive. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and live in us. God of compassion, we pray for those who cannot feel the joy of Christmas through the burden of sickness, bereavement, loneliness, or other distress. Comfort with your presence all who are separated at this time from those they love. Bring the light of Christ into their afflicted lives. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and live in us. God of unending life, bring life in all its fullness to us here, and have mercy on the departed, who, having shared with Christ their human birth and infancy, have shared with him also the death of the body. Make their joy complete in the kingdom, where there is neither birth nor death, but abundant life without end. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and live in us. God of warmth and brightness, we praise you for all your many blessings, and above all, for coming to transform us and set us free. Hear our humble prayer that we may serve you in holiness and faith, and give voice to your presence among us until the day of the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Please stand as you're able. Dear friends in Christ, as we continue to turn our hearts and minds to worship all-loving God, let us confess. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name.
Amen. Merciful God, grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. In the tender, the day spring from on high shall break upon us, to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of God be always with you.
And also with you. And also with you.
Please share a sign of peace with one another. good and loving God, we rejoice in the birth of Jesus, who came among the poor to bring the riches of your grace. As you have blessed us with these gifts, let them be a blessing for others.
With the trees of the field, with all earth and heaven, we shout for joy at the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
The table of the church and of God. It is to be made ready for those who love God and for those who want to love God more. So come, you who have strong faith and you who may have weak faith, you who have been here often and you who have maybe not been here for a very long time, you who have tried to follow and you who may have failed, come. Not because it is I who invite you, it is our Lord. It is God's will that those who want God should meet God here. May God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to God.
Let us our Creator.
It is right to offer thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, all loving God. And everlasting Creator, through Jesus Christ, your Son. For when he humbled himself to come among us in human flesh, he fulfilled the plan you formed before the foundation of the world to open for us the way of salvation. Confident that your promise will be fulfilled, we now watch for the day when Christ our Lord will come again in glory. And so we join our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and singing. On the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Generous God, as we bring this bread, and this wine, and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit, that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and blood. Pour your Spirit on us, that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. Praise belong to you, loving God, with Jesus your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
As our Savior taught us, let us pray.
Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin.
Promise you purpose in your kingdom.
Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Wisdom has built a house. She has mixed the wine and has set the table.
Glory to you, O God, forever.
These are the gifts of God.
Thanks be to God.
All are welcome at the table. When you come forward, I do ask that you go to the end of the altar rail so that others can come in behind you and then to leave from there. Please hold out two hands if you would like bread, one if you prefer a communion wafer. You may drink the wine, or please just touch the chalice if that's best for you. And you may stand or kneel at the rail. Thank you.
Peace on earth, Lord, hear our prayer.
us pray. God, for whom we wait,
in this meal you gave us a foretaste of that day. When the hungry will be fed with good things, send us forth to make known your deeds and to proclaim the greatness of your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Please stand as you're able. Glory to God, whose
power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. May the Sun of Righteousness shine upon you and scatter the darkness from your path. And the blessing of God, our Creator, Christ, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those you love always. Amen.
Jesus, let your kingdom
light the day.
bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And all are welcome for coffee and cookies at the hall across the lawn.